Yo, what's going on, everybody? Today's video, I'm going to give a quick guide on Deadline, and how to play it, what is it about, how do I play it, how do I start it, all the above. So first, let's give a brief description of what Deadline is while we're at it. All info covered will be in timestamps in the description, in case you can't really understand because I talk a little weird. 2 to 4 players will be placed on a floating platform above Los Santos, sandy shores, and or Palito Bay. They will be on different colored Chitaros, which I believe are green, orange, blue, purple, and maybe pink. The objective of the game is to take out the rival players by using the bike's energy trail to block their paths. Any player that touches the rival bike's trail will instantly explode, losing one of their lives, the number of which can be set by the host. Behind each player when they move on the Chitaro will be a line, and when an enemy player or yourself hits the line, they/you will explode. The bikes are scripted to not stop completely, only to a minimum speed that is considered acceptable. If the player dies, but still has lives, they will respawn with a few seconds of invincibility. If the player falls out of the arena, they will also lose a life. Touching their own energy trail, or crashing into an obstacle to stop the bike completely, also makes the bike explode. The player's bike will explode only if it touches an enemy energy train, not if they collide with the rival's bike. Once the player loses all their lives, they no longer respawn on the arena and are automatically the loser of the match once it ends, while the remaining player is considered the winner. If the time runs out and the winner... If the time runs out, the winner is the player who has the most remaining lives of the match. If there is no way to tell the winner, a sudden death round will be activated. In this phase, participants must stay within an area called Sudden Death Zone, represented by a dome. It is similar to the mode Penned In. If a player leaves the arena, they will be eliminated. Taking part in the round of Deadline unlocks a decommissioned Chitaro for purchase on Legendary Motorsport, and the outfits in any clothing store, whether the player loses or wins. There are 3 different power-ups: Boost, Zoned, and Hop. Boost allows the player's bike to receive a speed boost, allowing them to block the rival's player's path more quickly. Zoned allows the player to slow down time, allowing them better control over their bikes. This power-up lasts for 5 seconds. Hop gives the player's bike the ability to jump, allowing them to avoid energy enemy trails. My personal list would go Speed, Hop, and Zoned, because Zoned isn't all that useful compared to the other. The locations in the maps are as follows. Deadline 1 is located above Pillbox Hill. Deadline 2 is located above the runway of Los Santos International Airport. Deadline 3 is located at the Vinewood sign in Vinewood Hills. Sorry, I mispronounced that a little bit. Deadline 4, is located above the Sandy Shores Airfield, Sandy Shores. Deadline 5 is located above Terminal. Deadline 6 is located above Lake Vinewood. I keep messing up my words, I'm sorry about that. Deadline 7 is located above the El Gordo Lighthouse. Some glitches that can occur during gameplay are possibly due to internet connection issues and or / lag. When a player respawns, the bike could immediately explode. It may also happen continuously. The condition of game ends are as follows. The opponents or the player runs out of lives, the opponents or the player are eliminated during sudden death, and the Rockstar Newswire description is as follows. Turn the streets of Los Santos into a stylish electronic video game battle to the death with the latest update to GTA Online. Achieve hyperspeed on the futuristic Nagasaki Chitaro and demolish foes with the power of your light trail in the new adversary mode Deadline. The biggest tip I could give is just to play it smart. Know when to go after someone, and know when to stay away from other players. Once you're late game, as I like to call it, if you have more lives than your other opponents, and there's 2 minutes to 30 seconds left, avoid enemies at all costs, even if you want to murder them. If you look on the screen right now, I have 13 seconds to 12 seconds, and I have 3 out of 6 lives where my opponents only have 0 to 1. If you have more than them, you want to avoid them all, because they're probably going to go after you. Just stay out of their way, stay out of their sight, stay out of everything, and quick easy money. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next one. I just said that. I don't know why I said it. Peace.